So we're here in my living room, and I want to give you guys a short update as what's going on and what's happening and what the hell is going on. It's we're in the middle of January right now, and it's a new year, and the new season is coming in real soon, and my car is getting ready and ready, and hopefully soon, in a couple of weeks, we're going to be dynoing it. So that's all exciting, but that's another video series, and for those guys following that, you know, always check that out. But as you can already spot on the title, on this video, we're going to talk about something even more exciting than the brick. We're going to talk about my new garage, my dream garage. I never had my own shop. I had a small... I live in Copenhagen, and I never really had a spot to work on my own car. I've always been kind of cheap, so I didn't want to rent a big space because it's really expensive here in Copenhagen. And I never been much of a renter. I always just paid mechanics or painters or body guys or whatever to do most of the work, like I did with the whole fabrication part of the brick. So you don't really need your own shop for that. But the need for getting in my own garage has been getting bigger and bigger, and also it's a lot more fun wrenching on your own than just paying a guy to do it all the time. So, but I'm always been pretty good at making money, at least enough money to pay people to do it. So it's been fine. But at the level that I'm at right now with the car, I kind of need to do more work because I simply can't finance it. So I'm getting a garage. I'm gonna try posting some pictures here. I'm not that much of an expert video guy. If I was really cool, I would do this live and picture would pop up and I would show you with the mouse, but here in the first picture it should be the garage from the outside, and it's pretty much a square box with two entrances, and that's basically it. It's gonna be wooden garage, flat roof, nothing much, not much special. It's gonna be 88 square meters, and if you have no idea what a square meter is and you want me to say it in square foot, I have no idea how much it is in square foot. I'm probably gonna put it in the description, but let's just say it's gonna be 1 million square foot. So about that, that's my guess. I have no idea. It's seriously, go to metric, it's much easier. Here there's a drawing from the upside of the whole plan. I'm planning to have two rooms. It's gonna be reverse from what you can see on the drawing, but there's gonna be a garage area where you can park a nice car, like a Bugatti Veyron, a P1 McLaren, stuff like that. I'm planning to own both these cars this season, so keep on that. And if you're still believing this, I might not own any one of these shit cars. Of course, it would be... I really hope to maybe own like a Supra again, maybe a 350 Z as a track day car, maybe an MR2 as a track day build, a street Supra, maybe a Malibu, a G-body, a 70s Malibu, the square one with a big block in it, as a street car. So I'm bouncing a little bit between finding like a track day car, because I have a couple of friends doing track days, and that seems to be where, when you're getting done with street racing, you're going out to do track days. So I'll maybe do both, but I don't know. Or at least I wanted some fun street car, like a Supra, maybe a R34 Skyline. I know a guy that has one standing around that's not really doing anything, but I don't have the finances, so it might be a couple of years before I can buy anything like that. But at least my wife's Yaris can stand in the dry. It's gonna have heated flooring, so it's gonna be real nice. And then the other bay, or the other area, it's gonna be a workshop, as you can see on the drawing. That's the big area. It's gonna be 8 times 7 meters or something. So, and the brick is 5 meters long, so 8 meters in the width should be enough to get the brick in there, and so you can work both behind it and front end, and plenty of space. There's almost space for two cars in there, but I'm only planning to have one project car at the time. And the reason why I'm dividing it is because I'm also working as a construction worker or a carpenter, and the area could also be used for woodwork or paintwork or whatever, and it's pretty nice to just be able to take your nice car, put it next door, sealed area, and the other area you can just be dirty as fuck and paint and grind and whatever, and you don't have to worry about the nice car or the nice stuff. So that's also taken into consideration. So that's the plan. This weekend I'm gonna go out to the construction area and just do a quick video where you can see my dream garage getting built. And in the background there's a house getting built, but that's not irrelevant. I'm just gonna live there. No, I'm gonna sleep at the house and live in the garage. I already ordered the kitchen supplies for the garage, and my wife is asking me if I'm planning to live there, and I told her basically yes. So I need a fridge for energy drinks, microwave, and a little water boiler so I can make tea and coffee and stuff like that. So I never have to leave the garage. So that's basically it. Thank you for watching, and always stay fresh.